sense. You know, you just get right back up on it. But at the same time, you do want to have time to practice and boot camp, and they haven't had that time for that.
I mean, I like the term, and this has to be taken in a certain way, and I'll probably get a lot of people not agreeing with me with this, but Dignitas, I think just simply because they've been away for so long and completely been away from everything, you could class them as a dark horse simply for that reason. If they played so consistently and were around the whole time and played in every single tournament, you know, they would just be your standard household Counter-Strike name, but because they kind of disappear for a while, they can just pop up at events like Gfinity 3 here and, you know, cause some really big results.
Yeah, and be interesting to see if they're going to be in a position to play better and better throughout the tournament as they get it back into their groove, because if they're already playing well, it's definitely going to be fun to see. Now, we do have the knife round coming up, of course, here to decide who's going to be starting on what side. Not sure it makes a huge difference being on Dust 2. It's not like Nuke or Train or something like that, where you want to be on the CT side necessarily. But it looks like it's going to be Dignitas winning it anyway. So welcome to the show, everyone. This is the Gfinity G3 tournament. First time that we have Gfinity involved with Counter-Strike, and all the issues are still being sorted out. I know they're working really hard on it, so thanks for your patience. Give them a little bit of room to work with, and they are going to be able to do a lot for the scene. I'm pretty sure about that, because they're really, really excited to be trying to do this for the first time, and the venue is absolutely amazing.
It's crazy here. It's absolutely crazy. Yeah. If you are at home, I'm sure you're having a good time at home as well, but you're really missing out. The atmosphere is crazy. I've actually been working with the Gfinity guys right from their first event last July, I believe it was, and I've been to every single Gfinity event, which is why it's such a pleasure to be casting here again. And just to see the scale of it, actually Brycey, who's kind of like our manager as casters, he described it as G1 was G1, fair enough, G2 was G2, and now here G3, just the scale has gone so big, it's like G14 or something. So they've really expanded, and as Anders said, we do apologize for any delays and any issues we have, but we're just ironing out things, and hopefully for the rest of the day it will be getting better. And tomorrow, when all those big best of three matches come through in the quarterfinals, semis and finals, which are all single elimination, I can't even talk right now, we should have a really clean stream, hopefully.
It's always a bit tricky when you're doing production for the first time for a game you're not really used to. You know, you're going to be in a bit of a weird position. So that's what we're running into a little bit here, and I'm sure it's going to be working out just fine afterwards. Of course, we're waiting for the players to actually get ready. I think Fetish just readied up. So that's the Danish in-game leader, of course. And of course, I have to be rooting a little bit for Dignitas, being from Denmark
myself.
So there's a little bit of favoritism going into that. I hope it's not going to be too much of an issue. But I am excited about Dignitas as a team. But I mean, ESG at DreamHack Summer last time around, they really upset some big teams. They surprised a lot of people. So I wouldn't be surprised if they're going to be really good. And Delpan is definitely one guy to look for. The other one I would say is Mike Lilly, as the analyst desk also was pointing out. If those two both hit a really good form in this game, they can actually beat almost anyone, and that's a scary thought in itself, I think.
Definitely, and especially with the format that we're seeing today at Gfinity 3, where we've already discussed the crazy upsets and the weird results that we've seen so far, and the fact that those are already being taken into place, and we've got this best of one round robin format, anything can happen at any time. So luckily, we're hopefully going to be ready to get into the game as soon as possible. But yeah, I agree. I'm going to not be biased, but I think that Dignitas could take this one. We'll have to see, of course, anything can happen. But actually having a look at earlier results as well, virtus.pro did play ESG earlier on today on cash, and the final score there was 16-12. So ESG coming into this game off a loss, and Dignitas already with a big win over the French team of Titan.
Yeah, but playing 16-12 against virtus.pro on LAN is definitely not a bad result.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, you can't be too sad about that. Obviously, winning is even better, but here we go. We're about live, so welcome once again here. G3 Gfinity Tournament, the first time we've seen Counter-Strike in this, and definitely go to gfinity.net and check out the website and support them a little bit there, because they're trying to do the very best they can, and definitely with a little bit of our support as well, maybe it's going to be better and better all the time. Now, we see Dupree in the middle here, grenading, but they're all right around the corner. This is not a good position for Dupree, even with the 5-7 and all those bullets. He's not going to win against a full-on Glock train. They're going to flash their way in, and a sick shot comes through Dupree with an instant headshot.
Yeah, it does indeed. So Zipnik's here on the A-bomb site, just trying to get some cover in. In comes the Molotovs, and he gets a second kill there. So two-man advantage in for the CTs of Dignitas. And of course, if they can pick up this pistol round and carry that through, it's going to be really good for them. And have a look at this. 3 HP there for Skitten, and Rogue on 9 HP. Sorry, he's going to go down. It's all going to be left up in the hands here of Skitten, and he goes down. And just an initial point before we go any further, I do apologize if I pronounce any names wrong. I was told earlier on that I could get away with pronouncing Skutten. So if I do get that wrong, I do apologize, but that's not come from my mouth. So into round number two.
Unless you're Swedish, it really does become tricky. I mean, even I'm, you know, next door neighbor in Denmark.
You are,
of
course.
Even I have really a hard time doing it. So I think we're going to hopefully be forgiven. Or maybe we won't, but either way.
If we won't, well.
We're trying our very best. You can always tweet at us and try and see if you can give us some pronunciation lectures or something like that. We'll listen if we get any tweets like that. Now, there's a Bison picked up here on Sipnix. That's interesting. And Device down the middle taking a fight. There was no bomb plant in the previous round, but they have actually not bought any armor here, which is interesting. Mm. On the terrorist side, that is.
Yeah, it is. And you can see them just stacked up over towards mid at the second and lower dark. It'll be interesting to see where they eventually end up. All stacked towards there right now, and Dupree in a lovely spot, just hiding around the corner, just checking to make sure that nobody's going to be pushing through anytime soon. And we will see. T-Side can push it anytime. Dupree gets two. Dupree isn't going to get the third. No, he's not. Is he? Eventually, the pistol comes out, but it's not going to quite work. It doesn't matter, though, as Dupree was the only casualty. And that's going to be 2-0 on the board.
Actually, a pretty good hold coming out from Dupree, considering the position that he was in with the FAMAS. It's
yeah.
When he's trapped in the corner like that, if he had done the first peek, I would have expected him to pick up a couple of kills.
Yeah.
But because they peek him first, it's a little bit different. And FAMAS is not an ideal weapon for that corner, so it's going to be quick 2-0. Nothing surprising coming out from ESG here. They keep on with the pistols. No quick buy coming up in the third round.
No, we can see actually Zipnix has kept that Bison still, so he's obviously happy with it. And that's the man on our screen holding towards long doors at the second. There is a smoke in his way, and he is going to meet up with a couple of players, of course.
This could be beautiful.
It could. And let's see if they're going to push through. The flash grenade comes in. He's going to get two through the smoke. Make that three. As it's all going to be left up to Michael Lilly and Delpan. Make that the quad here for Zipnix. Is he going to finish them off in style? Yes, it's an eco, so we won't get too hyped. But still, through the smoke in that fashion. Very good job indeed. Dupree steals his ace. And 3-0 is your score. Let's see what ESG do here now that they're finally going to be able to buy.
That was 8,600, I think, on Sipnix at the at the beginning of this one. Obviously, he's not going to save the Bison because against armor, it does absolutely nothing. But that is a really big deal here. And the funny thing is, he killed three people and still had 24 bullets left because it has just so many bullets. But now we see Delpan, one of the guys that has to come up big in this match for the terrorist side if they're going to be able to win it. And well, you know what? He's already picked up an AWP, and that's a big deal.
It is indeed, and we will see if he's going to be put any good work to it. We can see lots of shots going down. Emilio finishing off Fetish there with the headshot over towards Long. There is another player, which is Device, actually, over towards Long, but he won't be met by anybody that he's just backing away from that area for now. So, as you would expect here on the T side, just taking things slowly. It's great that they've got the first frag here on the board in this fourth round, and I talk about this so much when I cast CS, about if you lose those, you know, initial first three rounds, obviously, after losing the pistol, as soon as you pick up rifles, it's so important to get that momentum on the board and start to bring the rounds back in.
No doubt about that. And down the middle, actually, really close. AC's going to go down. He was in a good position, but he gets taken out, and now Dignitas have a tricky situation on their hands, and I really love the fact that ESG are just slow playing this. An upper dark here, they're waiting. Dupree's going to go in, and Rogue, he was set up exactly for that push, so this is just a very smart play. And the Danes are actually playing right into what the Swedish team is doing right now. ESG are playing slowly and just picking people off as they come. It's very smart.
Yeah, and if it can work in your favor, of course, you can just keep doing it time and time again, and you've got to wait for Dignitas to try and counter it before you change anything. And we've had no casualties yet here from ESG. Zipnix somehow left alive on one single point of HP at the second. So we'll see if he can survive the round out. But the bomb hasn't actually been planted yet. Of course, they are going to save their rifles considering the position that they are in right now. Finally, the bomb's going to go down to Michael Ailey here. And this will be the first round on the board here for the T's. So pretty much, you know, standard so far. Nothing really too extraordinary and anything too special yet, so to speak. Although, of course, with that quad that we saw with the Bison earlier on. But it looks like it could already be shaping up to be a good game.
Flash in. Emilio's going to peek and does go down to Device. But if they can take away these rifles from Sipnix and Device, that's going to be huge. And Sipnix has one health. That's not a lot. So we'll see if he can actually go down here. One click. It's going to be all it takes. Or even a grenade, which they actually don't have any longer, so they can't really use that for anything. It's creeping up here. Rogue is going to go down. Straight headshot. Very fast reaction from Sipnix, and they're going to be able to save the last two rifles, which is a really big deal for Dignitas here. Means they can force it up this round. If they lose everything, it's a little bit different for them. But they do have a fair amount of money. 3-1 going into the fifth round, and that was a very, very good round from ESG. Mm.
Oh yeah, it was. They didn't look like they were bothered whatsoever about losing those first three rounds there. As soon as they were able to pick up those rifles, they looked strong. And here we go, Delpan once again. We spotted him out earlier on, and he did spot that player there over towards mid-doors. Didn't take the shot, though. And in come the grenades over towards B, so AZ's got to be alert. You can see him just checking over towards Upper Dark here and towards that tunnel. But the T's are actually backing off, so once again, taking this slowly. And we haven't had any single casualties yet here in round number five. Still plenty of time to go, though. The only person to take real any sort of damage is actually Skitten, down to 77. But it'll be interesting to see where the bomb goes. I have a feeling it's going to be pushing into B anytime soon.
I think you're absolutely right, Chewie, and it's going to be Dupree holding up here. Not exactly the ideal setup right now for Dignitas to deal with the B push, but actually, ESG, they switch it up in the last second, and that could be detrimental to them because they had the right timing to go for a B push, although they couldn't know it, but if they had committed to it, it would have been very different. Now they're going to be pushing if they go for A bomb side. The problem is that Device also has an AWP, and although he's no Delpan, he's definitely no slouch either. He can step it up, and if he gets the one entry frag, well, then all of a sudden, ESG are going to really regret not committing to that B bomb site. We'll have to see here. Kjotun is moving his way up short and looking to see if he can maybe just pick off anyone or do a little bit of, you know, damage to someone early on here. Device still looking towards that short area.
Indeed, and by the looks of things, the CT's sticking to their guns and not moving anywhere. You can see that two of them still are on that B bomb site, but in comes a flash grenade and in comes the push from the T's. Device tries to pick some shots up, but oh wow, he is able to pick up one there. And look at that, four frags in quick succession coming in from Dignitas. Finally, Delpan responds with the AWP, but it's all going to be in his hands. The man on catwalk on only 8 HP will be stopped in his tracks by Dupree. That was a good hold there from Dignitas.
It was, especially Sibnix with that double headshot in the middle of all of that. And I'm sad we didn't get to see that, but obviously there's no way of knowing who's going to be coming up with the action. But that was a very, very cool double shot. Now, he's actually Sibnix right now carrying the show. 7-2-1 as a scoreline. And the ESG losing that round means they're going to be right back to ecoing. If they had put the bomb down, they would have had the money to buy, and I guarantee you they would have gone for it. But they just don't. Now they're going to be going out on long instead. Flashbangs and grenade training. It's a double grenade for Fetish. And, well, they actually get two kills in return. Return with the Deagle just clicking people away.
Indeed, and Device back here on long, just looking down towards there, of course, is players who have gone down, have called out that position. And actually, we see ESG, they have been able to pick up two rifles here. Is it going to last for them, though? No, it is not. Confirmation as AZ finishes off with a double there for him. And that's going to move the score now to 5-1 in favor of the team from Denmark. And let's have a look at the economy. It's not really exactly too great if ESG are going to lose this next round once again. And we can actually see Emilio's gone for a Galil, but Delpan's got his AWP, so we'll see what work he can do with it. Or is he switching it?
Yeah, and this is because of, well, first of all, Mike Lilly is also very good with the AWP, but he got the spawn towards long. So the spawn position is what dictates who has the AWP this time. He's going to go for an instant peek, and he misses the shot and gets grenaded, and so does Delpan. So that's a real shame, and I wouldn't be surprised if Mike Lilly and Delpan are going to switch AWP and AK here. First of all, because he's low, but also just because I think they're going to keep Delpan as their main AWPer. But actually, they don't, and I definitely disagree with that.
Interesting indeed. And Dupree, you can see him in that boost spot there, looking up towards catwalk. He's going to eat a flash grenade to the face, though. Still is left alive, and he does take down to 20 HP. Eventually taken down, and that's going to be the first frag of the seventh round here. AZ responds, though, making things a 4-on-4 situation. AZ's going to try and get the second, but Michael Lilly, it turns out to be a good decision so far for him to keep that AWP as he gets the headshot onto AZ. So now it's a 3-on-4.
Now look at the way Dignitas are playing. Just like earlier, when they're a man down, they start pushing a little bit aggressively. And last time, ESG won the round just by waiting. This time, it feels like maybe the Danish team have a different plan here. They are staying where they are, and I think that's actually a good idea at this point. It's going to be really tough for Sibnix to stop them from putting the bomb down. But now that he moves back actually up on the A bomb side, it's going to be very different. So he's getting into a much better position now. If he can just hide and kill a couple of people, they can win this round. But obviously, ESG, they have the man advantage.
Yep, they do indeed. And it's about time that ESG showed us once again what they can do here on the T side of Dust2. And they're making their way up, and we can see that the players have actually backed away from the A bomb site. Now they'll be making their way quickly. Fetish coming through CT spawn. Zipnix is going to take out Emilio to start things off. So it's a 3-on-3 situation. And have a look at the HP there. Skitten and Michael Ailey on hardly anything. And jump shot comes in. Fetish takes down Skitten. So is this going to be a good retake here coming in from the CTs? We're about to find out. In they come back through CT spawn. Rogue's going to pick up one, though, onto Device, and it's all left in the hands of Fetish. Flash grenade over the top. He's going to check over towards Goose, gets the headshot into Rogue, and there's going to be one player left on 18 HP, but Mike Lilly. Wow, great plays with the AWP there. That was interesting.
Very, very important round coming up for Mike Lilly there, surviving on 18 HP, and They did use the flashbang at the end. I was a little bit annoyed that they weren't using them earlier because that was one of the big tools they had then to retake. Actually, it shouldn't have even been that close, but Dignitas did a pretty good job of defending early on. That leaves it in a 2-on-5 scoreline, and now is where ESG really needs to kick it into high gear. Instant shot from Delpan. So fast, going to take AC down to 20 HP. And are they going to be rushing? Yes, they will. Flash goes in. AC has so little HP here. One bullet is going to be all, but he still takes the headshot right for the smoke. Dupree goes down. AC in the corner will drop as well. And that's the B bomb side lost. So a big opening here for the Swedes. And this should definitely be their round.
Yeah, and the bomb's just about to get planted any second, which of course moves the pressure more so on the CTs, because not only have they got to take out those terrorist players, but they've also got to defuse. And somehow Zipnix picks up two huge kills. Two come back though, free SG. So it's all going to be left in the hands of Fetish. He gets one. Down goes Rogue. He gets the second as well. One versus two. Clutch for Fetish. Good night, Emilio. The bomb should be defused without absolutely any issues whatsoever. And what looked like a really strong round there for ESG, and what should have been a relatively easy hold, I would have thought, just didn't go their way whatsoever.
No, that was an absolute, that was a ridiculous retake coming out from Dignitas. And I think it was Delpan in the corner who didn't get the no-scope off. That was obviously one of the big mistakes there. That was a round that the Danes should never, ever have won. And ESG are going to be, they're in a really tight spot right now because they keep... They win a round and then they lose a round, and they don't have any money. Whereas Dignitas, well, they're slowly still building up. They're winning a lot of rounds on the less favored side of this map, and things are not looking good right now for ESG. And the sad thing is, it wasn't even like they did a really good job rushing that bomb site, and they had already softened up AC, so things were looking so tight. There's almost no way you're going to be losing a 2-on-3 like that.
No, definitely not. But still, Dignitas holding strong, showing us why, no matter how long of a break that they can take from this game and go on a nice holiday, they can come back and really prove their worth here at Gfinity 3. Flash grenades come in over towards Long. Zipnix gets one. Zipnix gets three. Down goes Skitten, Michael Ailey, Rogue, and he's going to pick up the quad there as well. Down goes Emilio. All left in the hands of Delpan. Yes, this is an eco, as you would expect, but if you can take out players quickly like that and finish off the round relatively easily, it should be good. Delpan, since then, has actually been able to pick up two kills. Eventually, he will be stopped by Fetish, and Team Dignitas just extending their lead now to 5. So 7-2 is your score heading into round number 10.
15-5-4 right now for Zipnix. He is by far the top fragger at the moment. I mean, Fetish is trying to step it up here with 11 kills, but everyone else is miles behind. In fact, right now on Dignitas, it's the Fetish and Zipnix show that's going on, and they have a 5-round lead because of it, as you said. And now the problem for ESG, and this is really a big problem when you have Delpan on your team, is they're going to have to force it up, but as a result, Delpan can't have an AWP, and they're running through, getting sprayed on down. Zipnix with another kill and almost takes down Delpan as well. And this is really scary here. ESG, they need something to go their way right now.
Oh, they definitely do indeed. And Delpan's also been knocked down to 33 HP, so of course you can still do some damage with that, but he's got to be careful very quickly. He's got that all-important AK-47 in his hands, and if he loses that one quickly and doesn't get any kills onto Dignitas whatsoever, it'll make the situation a 5-3 and almost confirm another round here for Dignitas. Of course, anything can happen here in Counter-Strike, and we can see that bomb actually stacked up over towards Long at the second, and we can see one player, which I believe will be Michael Lilly, actually in pit as it stands. So it'll be interesting to see where they go. Of course, still with 5 CTs up, they've got a great setup by the looks of things, and they're just happy watching their angle, taking things slowly and waiting for the eventual push here from ESG.
Now look at this here. This is really, really standard stuff coming out. Flash and then Fetish peaks right afterwards, and it's a really good idea. This is the really sort of the fundamentals of Counter-Strike, and a lot of teams seem to forget it. So if Dignitas are going to do stuff like that as well, they can definitely catch up a couple of kills on ESG later on here. Fetish in the corner now waiting, going to be almost taken down Hutter, but not quite. He's Device on 5 HP, and Device is going to get backstabbed. Mike Lady with the kill still up on the bomb side. It's going to be Zipnix, the man of the match so far, but he gets instantly taken down. Great headshot from Emilio, and that's going to leave AC and Dupree alone, and I don't think, even if so many members of ESG are very low, they should not go for this.
No, they're not going to, by the looks of things, making their way back up to T-Spawn, keeping that FAMAS and that M4 in hand. And we look at the HP there. Michael Lilly surviving on 12. Delpan still on 33 and Skitten on 5. So, very good take there. And that's exactly what I think the ESG needed. You know, we've seen a couple of times where we saw that, of course, that B take earlier on where they were really aggressive, got onto B and got the bomb down. But that was about it. And then just suddenly it all went wrong for them. But here, they managed to get those entry frags. They managed to get that bomb down successfully. And that's all they really needed to do. Round in the bag into round number 11 we're going to be going. And let's see if this is going to be the start of a couple of rounds in succession here from the team from Sweden.
Or if they can make it all the way to 8-7, it's still not going to be a great half for them, but at least they'll have a decent chance of winning. I mean, we saw how Fnatic mounted a pretty cool comeback on the on the Terrorist side, so or on the CT side. So there's room for it, but it's not going to be easy from here on out. And still, and this is the big thing, no AWP being picked up on Delpan right now. That's something we're going to keep highlighting. Dignitas, on the other hand, actually force up after saving those rifles. They buy three more for Masters, and they are ready to go here for the 11th round. They don't want to give ESG any room to get back in the game.
Nope, and rightly so, you know, with the lead that they've managed to rack up so far, I completely agree with their decision. Let's see what's going to happen. We can see that Catwalk is absolutely flooded with T players, and Device is going to have it all in his hands in just a few seconds' time, unless they stop the push. And they've suddenly stopped. They're just on the edge. So what looked like it could be very, very quick indeed may not be the case. They're just taking things a tiny bit slowly. Still no rotations from any CTs as of yet. I believe that's actually going to be AZ and Dupree holding mid, just checking if anything could be coming towards B as well. But in comes the push towards Catwalk. Zitnix, the man on your screen, is going to be the first line of defense. He's seen them up there. In comes the smoke grenade to try and give him cover. He's found one. Device gets one as well. In comes great work from the FAMASes of the CTs. Emilio eventually tries to get some revenge, but he's the last man left alive on 10 HP. He eventually gets finished up there with a pistol. And what happened wrong there for the Manders?
It's really hard to say, because the fact that they even got out on short was actually pretty scary. They ran through the smoke, which is not generally a good idea. But once they got up there, the Dignitas did not have a lot of grenades. It was just that the crossfire timing between Zipnix and Device up there was good enough that they weren't able to actually really do anything. Anytime they tried to peek one guy, there'd be someone peeking from the other side. So there's just really good communication and good timing from Dignitas. Instant shot on Delpan, of course. There's an eco round coming up from ESG. But this is spiraling out of control utterly for ESG. They are not looking good right now, and they're not finding very many openings either. I think that's the one factor. On the other hand, I think what we're also seeing is basically Zipnix having the game of his life right now. And that's hard to really account for when you're ESG. You can't really do anything about one guy just going off like he is at the moment.
No, that being said though, they have been able to pick up two frags here on this eco, so they won't be exactly too downhearted simply about that. But with the scoreline advancing in the way that it is, 9-3 is your confirmed score there going into round number 13. They need to pick up their game, and they need to do it now.
Zipnix has 20 kills in just 12 rounds. Just the start of the 13th one, this one is absolutely scary. Now there's a double AWP setup. Mykelele and Delpan both going to try an AWP. So that's an interesting turn of events. That's not too common on the Terrorist side of this map, but they are going to go for it anyway. One of them peeking down middle, and I'm not sure Delpan is also here in the middle. So they just want to make sure that Device isn't going to try and peek them. And if they can, maybe pick someone off on short here.
Indeed, it looks like that's going to be the case. Emilio does get the first frag, though, onto Fetish, and that's big. He has been knocked down to 14 HP, so once again, he's got to be careful. But this could be the start of a potential round win here for ESG if they can continue off from that first frag. Of course, though, we've seen Dignitas, even with the man disadvantage and the bomb being planted, being able to get some crazy retakes so far on Dust2, so you can't put it past either team as things stand. And with 1 minute and 5 seconds left on the clock, it's pretty slow here. You can see that that bomb is actually stacked up in lower dark at the second and not moving anywhere fast by the looks of things. Could be coming in towards Catwalk any second. We've got two players making their way over towards Long, so I'm not quite sure where the eventual push could be coming in, but I have a feeling it's about to break into something pretty crazy in just a few seconds' time.
I mean, with two AWPs, Long is definitely a reasonable choice, because if you go into the B-bomb side with that, it's not going to work out too well, maybe. Device with a really quick pickoff. That's one of the AWPs down now. We're going to flash in, and the question is, the guy from Pit comes up. It's Zipnix on the hunt again. He's going to get a quick double kill, and Device actually misses the next one. Delpan is going to re-peek. And this is not looking good. ESG had the round lead for us, or the man lead for a second. AC does go down, so they're going to try and bring it back. But the time here, Chewy, is what's really working against them. 20 seconds left. They pick up the one kill, but I don't actually think they can win the round anymore. Even if they rush with knives up, they're not going to be by that A bomb site in time, and Dignitas know it.
Yeah, they exactly know it, and that's why they've backed away from the situation that they are in, which is unfortunate for ESG. The fact that, you know, they had a good opportunity there to make their way through Long. Of course, that first, you know, quick shot that we saw Device pick up there with that AWP was pretty much the thing that almost stopped it in its track right from that point. They did get a couple of frags after that, ESG, but it just wasn't quite enough for them. And Zipnix there with two huge kills on Long as well from Pit with that AK-47 shut them down in quick fashion. They have been able to save those two AWPs there, which is of course something that they can take away from this, but we're already into round 14 and Dignitas are in double figures.
Yeah, two AWPs saved, definitely very nice, but it's not enough at this point. They need to be a lot more up than they are right now. Three rounds on the Terrorist side is way, way, way too little. So Ignitas, I mean, we said we thought maybe this was going to be a good map for ESG just because of the AWP range and having Delpan, but he hasn't really stepped it up like we should. And there's Device actually going to take down Mikelele. That's one of the AWPs gone again. And Device actually out-AWPing ESG right now. And that's not really, that's not what was in the manuscript.
No, definitely not. Delpan is going to actually respond, though. And we can see that AWP hasn't been picked up quite as yet. So that's going to make things obviously a 4-on-4 situation as things stands. And Dupree's going to find two there. Through the mid doors there, headshot into Rogue, and Delpan's going to get dropped. So we can see now that the two T players left alive have been able to keep their weapons. So Skitten's actually got that AK-47, which he purchased earlier on, and Emilio has picked up one of the AWPs that was in play. But still, this should be the 11th round on the board here for Team Dignitas. They've pushed the T's right back again. They're going to be making their way over towards Long, but they're going to be met by Zipnix here, and he's just been the king of Long so far from what we've seen today. He's been pretty much the king of Dust 2 from what we've seen so far in this match.
Yeah, I mean, pushing where Zipnix is holding is definitely not advisable at this point, but you got to do something, right?
Yeah.
He's hiding by the car. Are they going to check it? Gritton coming in. He's going to go down immediately, and Spray comes in towards Emilio. He's looking for the last kill, and he's going to get it as well. Actually, that was Dupree stealing that one, or Fetish, but either way, Zipnix gets another kill on the scoreboard, puts him up at 23, and we're looking for that 15th round where ESG tragically just do not have the money to buy, so they're going to have to force up. I think there's a scout on the other team, and they're just buying whatever they can to see if they can get one more round home here. But Chewy, even if they do, I'm not really convinced it's going to be enough.
No, I think it could at this stage already be past them. I mean, we've seen crazy comebacks, especially today this tournament. We know that they can happen in Counter-Strike, but still, just with the way that Dignitas are playing so far, it's going to be incredibly difficult. Dupree picks off two easy frags there as he sprays down towards the B tunnels. AZ gets another one, and Delpan is going to make his death there. And Mikelele will be down any second. There we go, confirmation of that.
Dupree wanted to knife him at the end there, so that's... That's definitely Dignitas with a lot of confidence.
And
I also question the wisdom of ESG wanting, I mean, rushing to be bombsite, you know, thumbs up for that. That's a good idea, because that worked for them once. But they actually wanted to rush through the Molotov that was put down, and there was flashbangs coming in as well. I think at some point you have to just abort that mission and go for something else, because that was not exactly the ideal tactical move. But I think maybe ESG have sort of halfway mentally given up at this point, and now it's going to be the pistol round on the second half here. A must-win round for the Swedish team. If they don't do this, they are not going to do anything at all.
No, well, we're only in round number 16, and pretty much every single round from now on is must-win for the Swedes, of course, because Dignitas are only four single rounds away from making sure that they get another win on the board here in Group B. Device is going to start things off well, so that's Delpan down to start things off. And have a look at Rogue. Yeah. One single level of HP left on him, and they're going to find loads of players in CT spawn. So Dupree, great choice there. Actually checking up towards the B bomb site there, but it's all changed in favor here on the CT side of ESG. We can see AZ, the man on your screen, trying to get that bomb down as soon as possible, but a quick succession of frags here of ESG have definitely put them back into this round.
Yeah, I'm actually really sad AZ isn't planting right now, because I don't think they're going to win this 2-on-4 either way, but putting the bomb down would be a really big help. So there's the bomb plant. Now he's in a 1-on-4, and he's going to get the one kill, then goes down. But once you're in that position, you really just want to secure your team the ability to buy in the third round.
Yeah.
And that's the difference between putting the bomb down and not. If they would have had to wait until the fourth round otherwise, so... Yeah, not the best pistol round coming up from Dignitas in spite of a great start. So a lot of credit to ESG for bringing it back and actually winning that round. That could have gone horribly wrong.
Oh, it could have indeed. And great to show some resistance from them that they haven't quite completely given up here on Dust 2 against Dignitas. They want to put up a good fight and give us all a good show here at the Copper Box Arena in London for Gfinity G3. So into round number 17 we go. And having a look at this, Dignitas have actually had an interesting choice of weapons. We've got an AK-47 and a Galil come into play. And Dupree's got loads of... grenades and armor as well, so very interesting. We'll see if they're going to be able to make any use of it whatsoever. I have a feeling they may not do, and Fetish has already been knocked down to 49 HP here, so I would be very surprised if ESG weren't able to take this 17th round.
Yeah, so this kind of buy is almost like an NIP-esque type buy. This is something that the Swedish champions do quite a bit, and it's interesting to see it coming out here from the Danish team. Not usually big fans of it, I feel, but we'll see. And you're absolutely right, Chewy, that, you know, you said you had a gut feeling it wasn't going to be working out, and so far it's definitely not. Device actually, kind of, he can't really save because there's so much time left, but if he can pick up a couple of kills, or maybe even three, this would make it a reasonable round. But otherwise, Dignitas have just given ESG room to get some rounds home here.
Yeah, they have indeed. And wow, great headshot down there through the mid doors. And of course, there are still four players left alive for the CT side, so Device isn't going to be able to do much here whatsoever. He's just going to wait for the time to run out, which, as you can see at the top of your screen, obviously is only about 30 seconds or so from now. But here is the question, Anders. Of course, if ESG start to get the ball rolling here, and they start to get going on this CT side, do you think it's possible for them to really come back into this game?
Yeah, it's always possible, and that's one of the reasons why Counter-Strike is such a fun game.
Yeah, but that's why I switched to it.
That's a really good answer. I would say that the odds right now are absolutely astronomical. It would be a miracle almost if that really happened. We're talking, divine intervention level comeback
right
here. It's very, very unlikely at this point, especially because Dignitas are very good at playing the terrorist side too. They are definitely a CT team. They're actually very strong in playing the CT side, so maybe it's not a huge surprise that they had that first half, but generally speaking, they are good at adapting on the T side too.
Yep, and they're actually completely broke right now, the Dignitas side, so echoing once again, and we can see that there are two CZ75s in play, but I don't think that's really going to do too much. In comes the rush towards B. Incendiary grenades are going to meet them, and Rogue actually picks up a triple to start things off. Yes, it is an eco, so we won't get too hyped, but still great for him to be able to finish things off. So that's actually the quad for Rogue there. 12-6 is your score, and going into round number 19, ESG are six rounds behind. Zipnik's still sitting on 24-6-9 for him. And in all honesty, although I'm liking the ESG really starting to try and put up a fight here, I honestly feel it's only a matter of time before Dignitas finish this one out.
ESG putting everything into this round. They actually had a FAMAS on Delpan, but they decide we need the AWP on him. So they throw it away, leave it in CT spawn, and just pick up the AWP. So that's definitely a clear sign of how much the AWP matters on this map for the Swedes. Again, I said it when the Danes were rushing, when the Swedes were rushing through fire, I said it last time, so again, I do sort of question the wisdom of running through fire like that to try and get into the bomb site. But I think actually, and this is maybe a bad sign, I think Dignitas wanted to get that round over with really quickly, and they can't think like that. They gotta put equal weight on all the rounds here, because if they feel like they've already won the game, that's exactly the point in time when ESG have a really good chance of making a ridiculous comeback. So keep their head in the game right now. That's the main thing, I think, for Dignitas. Can't assume that they've already won.
No, definitely not. And I wonder if ESG have picked up on that fact of how fast Dignitas played that last round. And almost, it was just a simple case that it didn't look like they really cared about it and was accepting, we're on a full eco here. Let's just get rid of this round and move on from it. And I totally agree with your point there. But in comes the push towards Catwalk. By the looks of things, Emilio's going to be the first line of defense, and he's not going to do much whatsoever. Two frags for Dignitas, AZ and Dupree, the men to start things off, and already the man in pit, Skitten, is in a horrible situation. The bomb's been planted. Dupree is on 12 HP, but by the looks of things, this is going to be a tough retake, and you've still got two players over on to B who aren't making any sort of move whatsoever yet, Anders.
No, they're obviously hoping to save, but they're kind of far away from each other, so if they get found out here, it could be a little bit tricky doing that. And actually, Delpan, look at how close this is. Fetish has walked right underneath his scope, and what an upset. This is not a fun situation for Delpan. Fetish should be able to get this kill unless he walks right in front again. He is actually just going to be creeping Delpan right around the corner. He misses the shot, or he actually gets it. Fetish down to 9 HP. That could have been Delpan dead, so I actually think he should be very happy he even stays alive. But they will save all the rifles here, and it's going to be 13-6. But that last round, it's really hard to stand up to entry frags like that. Getting the one was great. Jumping down and getting the second one, even better. And then what are you going to do? Now they are going to pick up two AWPs. So once again, it's the sniper rifles that are going to save ESG, if anything, here.
Yeah, definitely. And now we can see that Dignitas only three rounds away from being able to confirm it. And Michael Lilly with a huge shot there onto Device through the smoke. I'm not quite sure I managed to pull that one off, but that's why they're here competing at top level, because they can pull things like that off. And AZ responds, two frags into Rogue and Emilio. So the man advantage going back in favor of the T's. But as soon as I do say that, it's now even on a 3v3. And we can see the CT's have still got that double AWP setup into play here. And the T's just making their way up back towards mid, and potentially looks like they could be making a catwalk push here. But I'm liking this setup, and it'll be interesting to see who takes this one. I think it's going to be, again, who's going to be able to get those early entry frags onto the sites. Of course, with only three players left alive, those CTs are going to be split up now. One over towards B, just one just watching CT, and one on that A site as well. So it'll be interesting to see who's going to push through first and where they're quite going to go. But that bomb's making its way over towards catwalk.
Yeah, I mean, it's all going to be on Hythania. One grenade won't do too much damage. He has to stay alive for a very long time. He can't go down. He will go down. Delpan with a sick shot on Fetish. Very, very important kill here. Now the retake is looking a lot more likely, and they are already realizing there could be one guy down on long. And that's probably Hythania already calling out to his teammate, telling Rory, I only saw two people. Probably the last one is going to be long, and they plant for long as well, I think, if I'm not mistaken. So now it's really tricky. Retaking the bomb site with two orbs is not an easy task. If anyone misses a shot here, then Dupree's gonna get an easy kill on Delpan, but he's sneaking around. Delpan already scoped up. He's just creeping up and he's gonna pick up the kill. Very smart play from Delpan. And now it's Sipnix, the man of the match so far, looking to see if he can deny this defuse. It's a one on two. They do have kits right now. They're trying to defuse it from behind. He's not gonna be able to do it. He gets the one kill and the bomb is defused. Mike Hilele is gonna get it. And ESG win that round. Very, very nicely done. That was a scary one for them.
Yeah, that was a really, really close round indeed. And they were able to defuse it well. So Michael Lilly and Delpan just doing some great AWP work. And it's that Counter-Strike timing, of course. You know, if that player who was just on that A-bomb site there at the end, you know, hadn't been looking over towards Catwalk and had been still looking over towards CT spawn, there was a good chance that he was going to be able to pick up a quick headshot with the AK, but it wasn't the case.
And a good illustration, I think, of how much it matters where you put the bomb down, because I actually just assumed, because they had the time for it, that they had gone for the long plant.
Yeah.
But they didn't. They planted what was normally called the safe plant or the standard plant, and that's behind the box. So that's why Sipnix couldn't actually do anything. So that's also a tiny interesting detail. A little bit of a shame for Dignus House, because it could have been different. But ESG, they're really thankful, I think, that that bomb went down on the other side.
Oh, definitely indeed. And here we go. Michael Lilly already the first casualty in round number 21 we go. And let's see who's going to take this one. Dignitas are so, so close. And again, I have a feeling that it could, in all honesty, just be a matter of time. I don't want to take anything away from ESG because they have started to improve since switching over to the CT side. But still, Dignitas have shown us when they need to perform, they can do indeed. But as soon as I say that, Rogue is going to get a nice kill onto Zipnix there, the man of the hour. Device responds, though, onto Rogue, actually, I believe that was. And AZ is going to be starting to push in Delpan with the AWP shot onto Fetish. Back and forward, play between these two teams. Device gets in on the B bomb site, and that's going to leave it clear. But the problem is that the bomb's only now just making its way through onto the B bomb site, which has led for a chance here for ESG to start to think about pushing in. They're not going to do it, though. They will have heard that that bomb has gone down. And let's see if Skithen and Emilio can get this 2v3 retake.
They just don't have any grenades. They have the one kit here, but this is a really big problem. They can't rely on any flashbangs or anything, and they're also wasting a lot of time here. So we'll see that AWP covering the doors, and the window's been covered by Dupree, and that's also a guy in the upper dark, so it's actually almost impossible. If you could put in a really good flash, or even better, a smoke grenade to try and, you know, get the AWP to look somewhere else, that'd be really good. They don't even get away with Emilio here. Krypton is going to be picking up an AWP and running away. That's about the best thing we can say about this round for ESG. That's 14-7 now. Dignitas doubling the round score of ESG and having a really, really good game on their hands. And the money for ESG, I mean, they are going to force it up here because I don't think anyone wants to play for a draw. So I'd be very surprised if they don't.
Yeah, indeed, I would be. So we will see what the situation is going to be for them. Of course, Krypton saving that AWP. And here we go. Actually, Delpan's going to pick one up. So that's very interesting indeed. So it's going to be a complete mix by here. And what do you think of that, Anders?
It kind of fits their style, I would say that much. You know, I think a lot of the teams would have kept the one AWP. They would have got two FAMASes and had more rifles on everyone. But they are a sniper-heavy team. That's what we're seeing here. Sipnix right through the smoke, takes down Emilio, and that's a very annoying start here for ESG. Obviously, losing this round would lose them the game. They just won't have any money for the last round. We'll see. Mike Lele is still up in this bomb site with the AWP, and where's the other orb, actually? Delpan has it all the way down the middle, I think.
Yeah, by the looks of it, I think it could be indeed. Emilio going down to start things off, as we've already mentioned, is not the best start that ESG would have wanted here. In comes the shots going down over towards Catwalk, but actually, ESG have made a really good comeback into this. It's only going to be Device and Dupree left alive. Device making his way up from long, and they have got control of the A site, and it looks like it's going to have to be a 2v3 retake.
And that peak, you see Device jumping up on the box, looking down CT spawn, instantly tells him, all right, it's going to be long or short. And in fact, he's wrong. So this is going to be a little bit tricky. He's flanking all the way around, and this could be a genius level play coming out from Device. If Dupree stays alive for just a little bit, they're not going to have a lot of time, and if he just kills the defuser once, that's going to be it. Dupree with one headshot here. Device coming up from behind, taking down Hutton, and that's Dupree with the final one. And that was perfect, absolute expert timing coming up from Device, and obviously Dupree with the triple kill, making the big difference in that retake. So there it is. Still Sipnix top fragging, but Dupree is catching up.
I've really been impressed by all of them so far. I have to say, Device, again, another player who's really stood out to me so far from what I can see. He's only sitting at 16 and 11, but just, you know, the frags that he's been picking up have been at such crucial times. And Device, there we go, the man of the hour, picks up Delpan, takes him out of the game. And that could, in my opinion, and I think a lot of other people's opinions, probably be the last time we see Delpan here, at least at this stage in this match here on Dust 2. But Dignitas coming out strong from what we've seen so far. Not quite over yet. We have got an SSG. FAMAS and a couple of pistols in play here for ESG, but this is just last-ditch hopes for the Swedes.
Yeah, it feels like even if they should, by some miracle, win this round, the road ahead is so long, and Dignitas have proven time and again that they can win rounds in a number of different ways, so it isn't looking all that likely. Oh, I don't know. I mean, that's the problem, I suppose, with having Delpan and Michelele be the two people to really carry the team. Is that if they then don't, there isn't that much hope left at the end. Good shot from Rogue's going to take down AZ, but they're also losing the A bomb side of the meantime, and they haven't had that much luck retaking it yet. Michelele is looking for the jump shot here, which only you can really do with the scout, but they're also shooting back at him. Emilia with a great headshot. Pistol comes in here and almost gets the kill. That would have been nice, but it's not enough now. Emilia with a 1-on-3. And bomb is down.
Yeah, bomb is down. Zipnik's only on 11 HP, Device on 34, but I have a feeling a 1v3 clutch retake and defuse is going to be a bit difficult. Maybe not, though, as he does pick up that first frag there onto Zipnik. So let's have a look, though. We can see that those two players for the T side of Dignitas are very, very close together indeed. Emilio makes his way onto the bomb side, checks Goose. Nobody's going to be there. Tries to find the shot. Not going to happen. Dupree finishes off. In comes the GGs, and there we go. You even see it on your screen with that lovely little graphic. Dignitas take out the team of ESG in a pretty convincing fashion.
Yeah, the Danes looking happy right now, and you know, I don't really blame them. That was a solid performance from them. Now, I don't know. I have a feeling if you replayed this match on this map 10 times in a row, there would be one of those matches where you would see Delpan hitting every single shot.
Yeah.
And they'd have, you know, the double up setup would be so good that it would be very hard to really do anything about. So, you know, it's just that I think maybe the majority of the time, you know, let's say 7 out of 10 games, I would say Dignitas are gonna win this.
Yeah.
But then, you know, if you hit one of the last three, you know, ESG can take it.
You can take it. But of course, in this best of one round robin format, it's just what happens on the day in that one single game that counts here. And that's going to put Dignitas in a hugely great spot.